Are you more asking about like how we've documented in the past and that experience?
Oh, right, that makes sense.
Okay, so we made this as a DRY, which is a wire vendor that basically draw a line as quick and bends the wire. So we documented it to the nines. We gave like not only a BOM, but we gave catalog numbers, we gave instructions, we gave everything. We put videos on YouTube on how to assemble it. We gave instructions on how to improve it in places that we wanted to improve it. We put instructables up on instructables, make project. We put up the code, the Google code, the all sorts of readmes, and we put this source code up on GitHub. And it took a long time to do all that. And then when I started, that was our first foray into open source at all. We said we should open source it, so we figured that's how you do it. And then we went out and found that there's a huge variety. Like, some people just say you should put screws, and bolts, and you know, and there's some people who give you like specifics, and then we get actual catalog numbers. So I'd love to see some sort of like standardization of, I'm sure everybody wants the same thing, but also the documentation of like, you know, a BOM is not an instruction list, and it's not even, it's barely a recipe. So that was one of the things that we realized that it's not only that it would be helpful if people want to use documentation to learn, but it's also that I can take apart a thing and identify a screw. That's not for the documentation, right? So the next thing is that we made the 2.0, which is this one, which was 2D and stronger and better in all sorts of ways. But the thing is that we never documented it because it took us so long to document the last one that we basically never got to it. Which is kind of a bummer because I really want to document it, but by the time I got to the point that I got documented, I improved it. So then I had to document the improvement so that I said, well, why don't we wait until I'm done? And then the problem with hardware projects is that they're never done. So I don't know, there we are, it's undocumented. And that's it. So people like keep asking for the documentation for this, and like, well, it's the same thing, just stronger, use stronger bumpers, and that's not really good. So then now we've done this one, and then this one's really more of a production level. So then there's this sort of thing here that, you know, at a certain point in your business, if you want to be a business, so at what level do I document this versus document that? They're exactly the same, but this is just sexier. And they work exactly the same and everything else. And to me, the way I documented the first one, if you look at it, it was made out of wood, made out of chop saws, the standard tools that you can buy at Home Depot. We told you how to build it with tools that you can get. If you wanted to make that top plate, you would need a 300-ton steel press, which you wouldn't have unless you're a factory. And it's also perfectly fine to use a chop saw. It just doesn't look good. It's not cost efficient for production. So for us to document that, it's sort of, I'm closer to the approach taken by DIY drones, where they say, well, look, for the parts that are you can make, we've open sourced that. For the parts that you need a factory to make, they weren't going to open source that. But, which I think some people are for, some people are against. The way I see that was that if people are interested in building their own, I'm going to give them all the information to build it for themselves, and I'll document it in such a way that you can. Sort of like, if you want to make a Martha Stewart recipe, most people can't do that, because it's just ridiculously cumbersome and you need a professional kitchen to do that. So you could read a real simple recipe and pretty much get similar results. So we're probably going to document the last one, and then if you're interested in building it, it'll give you the exact same results and uses the same software, and the code will be open source. But if you're interested in selling one, you can sell one that looks like that, or improved, or derivative of that. But if you're interested in like stamping on your own, I'm on the fence. So I just want to bring up the variety.
Yes. What's it called?
DIY.
DIY?
Yeah, so make your own wire.
It's genius, man.
Oh, thanks. Good. You can either make that one or buy that one. Sounds okay.
All right.